We are here with Kate, and we're going to show you how to do some tight mermaid waves. So I have a 3/4 inch curling iron, and I am going to start from her front, and I'm going to curl back. And I am going to start halfway down, and I'm just going to kind of keep twisting and curling to the root, and letting it out a little bit at a time as I go. And then as I let it out, I kind of twist it a little bit. And there you go. Little cute little spiral curl. And then I'm gonna start the next section about a half inch back. And the same thing, start halfway down and just keep curling it up to her root. And then just kind of letting it out slowly. And as you let it out, just twist it as you go down. We're gonna kind of just let these curls kind of like cool off before you run your fingers through it or anything, because I want it to be bouncy, and I want them to not all the way come out. And sometimes if you don't let them cool off, then they won't stay like bouncy. So again, just taking about half inch sections as I go back, and then just curling it down. You can switch the way you curl them too. Like some you can go forward and some you can go back. But like around her face, I kind of always curl them back. And you could also do this and make the curl not so curly by not twisting it as you let it out. But hers I want to be extra curly because I'm gonna do some cute braids with it. And then as I get towards the back, I'm gonna start curling some forward too. And you can do this with so many different size curling irons. Like you can do it, if you wanted, you could do it with smaller, like we've done it with 1/4 inch, right Kate? 1/4? Mm-hmm. We've done it with 3/4. Kind of the same thing if you wanna do it, if you want them bigger, you just use 1/4 inch curling iron or 1.5 inches. And then just move your way around the head. And if you're obviously like in a hurry, you could also take bigger sections and it won't be as curly, but it will still work. And then it won't take quite as long. But with these, I'm taking, as I go to the back, I'm taking like inch sections about. Also, it helps so much to use good hair products too, because a lot of times if your hair has buildup on it, or if you use like really heavy, greasy shampoos, like store-bought shampoos, then your hair will be so heavy and it won't curl. I have my girls like probably once a week, or if not more, like clarify their hair super good so that their curls will stay. Because if you use Pantene or store-bought shampoo, they have so much wax in it, and people don't understand that it will make their curls not stay. And you kind of just keep having, need to like open up the curling iron so that it will barely open up the, when you're twisting it, so it won't get stuck. Like I just kind of curl it down and then I open it up and then it won't get stuck on there. Okay, so now I finished all of her curls and I'm gonna have her flip over forward. And I'm just gonna take this Unite texture spray. And I'm just gonna spray, nothing crazy, just to give it, just to make it hold and give it a little poof. And then there you have it. The bouncy mermaid curls.